Hallelujah. Are you ready for the word of the Lord this morning? You ready for a word from the throne room of the King of all kings and the Lord of all lords? As I am honored and blessed this morning to welcome to you, and you will already know who he is, as we ask God to pour his anointing and his power and let his spirit flow this morning. I wanted to just say happy Father's Day to each and every one of you that is in this place. It takes a lot to be a father. I'm not talking about a baby daddy. I'm talking about a real father. A father that knows how to take care of their children. A father that knows how to speak life more abundantly. Are you listening to what I'm telling you? I want to say happy Father's Day to every father that is in this place. We salute you, not just today, but every single day, because of the hard work that you have done in everyone's life. Your children, your grandchildren, your own wife, and especially your wife's life. Come on, a father. He's a father. He's a father. Can we give him a hand of applause this morning? Just to say thank you, fathers, for who you are this morning. We salute you not only today, but every single day. Give your man a kiss and tell him, thank you, baby, for being my baby father. Come on, give him a kiss and say thank you. Happy Father's Day. Amen. We bless him because he deserves to be blessed. In Jesus' name, we want to say thank you for your affection. I want to tell my husband, thank you. I know he always talks, right? And he always say all what he say, but I'm going to get a little deep. And I'm going to tell him, thank you, my love, for your affection. There is something, you know, you could be a daddy, but it takes someone special to be a father. Come on, somebody. A father, if he is faithful. I can talk with boldness this morning. My father, he is my father. Didn't y'all know that? He's not just my husband, he's also my father. He is, F is for faithful. A is for anointed. Come on. T is for he's always on time to do what he needs to do to make it right. Come on, somebody. H, he is a holy man of God. Hallelujah. E, he is everlasting. I'm going to have him from one level to another for the rest of my life. I'm going to have a talk with Jesus about when we end up leaving this place, because I want to be with him after this place. F-A-T-H-E is everlasting, and he endures until the end. R, somebody say, a righteous man of God is what you're looking for, sisters. A righteous man of God is what you are going to need. So my darling, my love, my king, that's my king. I can kiss him, I can love him, I can hug him, I can squeeze him, I can do whatever I want to do. That's mine. I tell y'all, we ain't religious up in here, we are spiritual. So we do what we do behind closed doors, and we do what we do here, because this is what we are made to do in this earth. So I want to thank you for your affection. He's so affectionate. I want to thank him for his affection. I want to thank him for his compassion. Very compassionate, very soft-spoken, but when he don't like something, you won't get it right. But very compassionate and love. I enjoy being in the presence of my king. That's my king. I serve the king of all kings, but while I'm on this earth, he is my king. Come on, y'all. The Bible tells us, our Father which art in heaven, he said, hallowed be thy name, your kingdom come, your will be done on this earth just as it is in heaven. So while we are on this earth, he is my king. Telling me that, I want to just say thank you so much for telling me all the time. I mean, he tells me all the time that he loves me throughout the entire day. I love you. I love you. That's affection. You understand what I'm saying? I'm talking to some men, and I'm also talking to some ladies. What you gonna look for? Don't settle for anything. You better get the best. You don't just want to get better than before, but you want the best. Amen. So I thank you for telling me that you love me throughout the entire day. I love you. My chewy cake. He calls me all types of good stuff. For holding hands with me in public. Some men, they don't want to hold your hands in public. They don't want everybody to know that they belong to you. But my baby father, he holds my hands. Just like Jesus, he's holding your hand right now. Come on, somebody. I thank you for holding my hands in public. I thank you for coming to sit next to me, my love, for no reason. You just come and sit next to me for no reason whatsoever. I want to say thank you. Not wanting anything in return. but just because of his affection, his compassion, and his love that he has for myself and his family. Calling me on your way home faithfully every single night. My man called me from his way from work every single night. Not that I have to know that he's on his way home, but I'm happy to hear his voice on his way home telling me that he misses home before he leaves home. Come on. You don't think that's my king? That's my king. Somebody say, one day I'm going to get a king. I thank you for fulfilling my needs daily. Sounds like Jesus to me. Are you listening? Thank you for fulfilling my needs every single day, telling me how much you love me and how much you adore me and how beautiful I am, and making me feel really good. I thank you. How much you need me and how much he wants me. Yeah, he be telling me all that stuff, y'all. Baby, I need it tonight. Baby, I want you tonight. I want you now. I want you forever. And I wanted to just let him know that I thank him for everything that he does. Opening my car door for me, I thank you. And riding on your back when I don't feel like walking, I thank you. I want to say thank you for kissing me before you leave home from work. And kissing me on your way back, kissing me whenever, not caring about what anybody gonna think about the kiss, but I want to say thank you. Come on. I just want to just let him know how important he is, calling me many times a day just to say I love you. How many of you love to be said, said I love you? I love to be. My daddy told me that all the time. My biological daddy told me that all the time. Thank you for duplicating my father's footsteps, because I always wanted somebody like my daddy. Amen. Thank you for being that affection. Your affection is compassionate. Your affection is pure. His affection is really true. It's sincere. And it's kind. And it's like no other. Are you listening? He is like no other. And for this alone, you're the best father. For this alone, you are the best father that I know in this world. Besides my daddy, of course. He's the best father. Not only who you are to your children, but also to your wife. It's very important that they play that role model as father, as husband, as everything God has chosen them to be. He is always in the presence of Elohim. He is always in the presence of, in our home, in the presence of God, who prays over his family faithfully, faithfully every single day. He gets up and he says, he prays with the children, and he prays, and he comes together, and he prays. Thank you for speaking life into your children and into my spirit as well, to make me to be stand strong and to continue to do what I do for the kingdom of God. I thank you. I thank you for protecting us and providing for us. I thank you for being what God has chosen you to be. He is a priest in the home. He is everything that we will need. Amen. We don't have to fear. We don't have to worry. He protects. He guides. He shields. He covers. He speaks life. He's a prophetic man of God. When he speaks it, you got to watch it because it will come to pass. Amen. So I want to say thank you this morning, not only today, but every single day of what you do and who you are and whose you are, submitting under the authority of the King of all kings and the Lord of all lords. I salute you and I say thank you this morning. Amen. Let us all stand to our feet as we get ready to hear a word from God, an awesome father, an awesome husband, an awesome man of God who has a heart of God and who likes to dance like King David danced. Amen. I just thank God for him. Please help me welcome this morning as you get ready for a word from God. I know the fathers will be blessed this morning, and I know that you would learn something this morning. We have to go through pain in order to come into our purpose. We have to go through in our past experience in order to be where we are today. So I'm here to tell you to get ready, get ready, get ready for a word that is coming from my King. Pastor Marcus Green, can you please put your hands together and welcome my husband this morning as he brings forth the word of the Lord in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Brothers, I'm going to keep it 100. It just don't automatically start like that. You know, you got to work on it. That's something you just got to work on. It just don't automatically snap a finger and then you're an awesome father. It's just something you just got to work on. Daily. Sometimes you got to say, devil, get out of my feet. When Jesus was in the garden and the devil came and tried to tempt him, he stomped on the serpent. He said, devil, get under my feet.
Yes.
Sometimes you got to rebuke it.
Yes.
Just to turn it around. We'll be right back. Lord your God, I bless each and every one of you. I want to give a special shout out, a salute to the fathers in the house and the ambassadors, of the kingdom. All the fathers across the world, everyone that's watching across the world, we salute you here at the Ambassadors for the Kingdom. My God, thank you so much for tuning in. You could have been somewhere else. Thank you so much for trusting in God. Men, you are a builder. Not only a bodybuilder, you are a kingdom builder. Talking to my brothers. Doesn't matter where you are, near or far, I salute you. I know it gets hard sometimes. But the struggle is not over. Pick yourself up. Stand up. Shoulders off. You're the man. You're the king. I call you holy. I call you righteous. You were made in his image. King. I salute you. And thank you for who you are. Come on, let's bless us. All the fathers in the world. All my brothers in the house, thank you so much. And as I get ready to deliver the message, a message so powerful, I think it might be the best message I would ever preach, I would ever deliver to your spirit man. It's not only for you, I'm talking to the ladies too. Stands by the man. Sometimes he needs to lift it up. Speak to that man. That spirit man. Speak to him. Tell him how much you love him. Build him. Tell him who he is. We love that. We love to make our own problems. Lord. A father. A father. God said, gives his only son. Why? For who? Father. Why? For whom? For you. Why? The Father loves you. The Word said He gave His only begotten Son because of love, because of love. Can I get a little deeper? Because of love. What is that, Father? There are certain characteristic traits that a father should have. I mean, it's in your DNA. We come from the Father. We were created in His image. Can I get a little deeper? Certain characteristics. And women, if He is worthy enough to have a child with, He should have these certain characteristics, certain traits that He should have to call Himself a father. A father. A father is a protector. Number one. A protector. He protects. Women, He's concerned about you. Family, He's concerned about you. He's a protector. And sometimes it might get on your nerves. He would ask, where you at? Call me when you get there. Make sure you look around you. What time are you leaving? What time you'll be back? Who's that? Are you okay? He's a protector. He's concerned about you because He's a protector. It should be something inside of Him to make Him sure. To make sure that you're safe. Because everything that is assigned to Him, He protects. Wives, look at your man and say, thank you for protecting me. Men, look back at your wives and say, baby, I got you. Oh my God. He's a protector. And sometimes He protects you from things you don't even see. He protects you from the enemy. He protects you against fraud. He protects you against stress. He protects you against trouble. Sometimes He protects things that you can't see. Am I going somewhere? Sometimes He protects you from things you can't even see at all. And yes, sometimes He deals with things that you don't even know about. He deals with stuff in absolute size. Because he's a protector. When the Bible talks about a man being the head, that means he's the covering. He protects. He's covering. Because everything that comes hits him first. Are you understanding me? The force of the wind hits him first. And as a leader, trouble hits you first. I'm protecting everything that's behind me. Because you don't get it because I'm standing in his way. And get this. Brothers, get this. Sometimes people don't even realize or recognize your worth until it's taken away. And then when the force of the windstorm comes, that's when you hear, "Oh Lord, I didn't know he did all this stuff. I wish Fred was here. He knows how to handle all of this stuff." They don't appreciate you now because you're blocking the wind. Everything behind you is protected. The family that's assigned to you is protected. Glory to God. Protection. And a good man is recognized by the fullness of his worth upon his departure. Because everything that wouldn't hit you, now you got to deal with. The Bible says when Elijah followed Elijah, all he had to worry about is putting water on his hands. And when Elijah went up to the chariot of fire, Elijah had to pick up the old man's mantle, wrap it together, and say, "I'm going to get across this river. Because if Elijah's, if my father's, but nevertheless, if God did it for my father, I know he'll do it for me." A protector. Number two, he's a provider. He's a provider. He provides. I'm not talking about just money. He provides wisdom. That father provides friendship, counsel. He provides a perspective. He provides insight. He has a giving spirit. He adds to your life. Your life is fuller and richer because of him. is in it, and not necessarily issues. It's not necessarily an issue over who makes the most money. He's still the provider. He's in there stretching everything. He can provide because he's a contributor. He is a giver. And if you got a stingy man with a stingy spirit, get this, with a stingy spirit, let him go. Leave him alone. Don't date him! Because if he's stingy at 20, he'll be stingy at 70. Leave him alone. I don't care if he's fine, he's done, he's Perignon wine, 1950. Leave him alone. Good man is a giver. And I'm not talking about giving you every penny. Because you know some women wants everything more than the Wells Fargo bank. You get what I'm saying? I'm not talking about everything. I'm talking about a provider that is sensitive to your needs. Come on, somebody. A provider. What I'm saying, you should have the DNA. You know, God said man, that he created man in his own life.